Hello viewers, welcome to another video. In this tutorial, we will perform insulation resistance test or commonly known as Megger test on a three-phase electric motor. Here you can see the inside view of terminal box in which there are six terminals labeled as U1, V1 and W1, W2, U2 and V2. We first see the winding configuration inside this electric motor. The first set of the winding is connected between W1 and W2, the another between U1 and U2, and the last set of the winding is connected between V1 and V2. For a star or delta configuration electric motor, you will normally see this connecting strip. For star configuration, this strip is connected such that one end of all the windings are shorted together. And to make it in a delta configuration, this connection strip is connected between the windings like U1, W2, V1 and U2 and W1, V2. So the first step before performing the insulation resistance test or the Megger test is to remove any kind of connection strip to isolate all the windings. For testing purpose, you can either use the top side of the terminal or the winding or the bottom side of the winding. So I will be using the top side of the windings, and also the testing voltage will be 500 volts. This voltage is set depending on the voltage rating of your electric motor. For the electric motor rated for 400 volts, normally the test voltage is 500 volts. So let's begin the test. Here you can see on my left side is the step-by-step procedure in which I will going to perform this Megger test. First, I will check the insulation resistance test between the sets of windings. So the first set will be W2 and U2. Now connect the red probe with W2 and the black probe with U2 and press the test button. The test voltage is already set to 500 volts. As soon as you press the test button, the test voltage will be applied on these two terminals and the result will be shown on this meter. Here you can see the meter is giving us the result of 500 megaohm, which shows that the insulation resistance between these two sets of windings good. Let's move to another step, which is U2 and V2. Similarly, connect the red probe with U2 and the black probe with V2 and press the test button and repeat the procedure. You will see the result on the meter. If the meter shows higher value of megaohm, it means that the insulation resistance between the windings is good. Now move to the third set, which is V2 and W2. Place your red probe on W2 and the black probe on V2 and again repeat the procedure and take the reading. Now the next step is to check the insulation resistance between one end of the winding and the other side is the ground. Mostly in an electric motor, the whole casing is already grounded. So you put the black probe on any side of the casing. The red probe is connected to W2 and the black probe is connected onto the casing. And again, repeat the procedure by pressing the test button and take the reading. Now repeat the same procedure by connecting the red probe on U2 and keeping the black probe on the casing and take the reading. And finally, place the red probe on V2 and take the reading. Here, you can see that the reading is in points, or you can even get the 0 megaohm. It indicates that the winding insulation has failed and the coil is shorted with the body of the motor. In such a case, the motor cannot be used safely and the windings must be rewound before the motor is put back into service. I hope you understand how to perform the insulation resistance test or the Megger test on three-phase electric motor. For more interesting videos, stay tuned and don't forget to subscribe our channel. Thank you for watching.